We got that la 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 la. Pull up, pull up, pull up straight from Tokyo. You cannot believe it when we. What's going on?
Here. So today I'm going to be filming my hair routine for you guys. I'm also going to be doing mine sit down chit chat style like Kendra did, just because I feel like this way I can give you guys more details about the products, because I find that when people watch videos when you do voiceover, most people watch them without sound. So you miss out on a lot of information if you watch the video without sound. So I figured that if you see me sitting down talking, then you will be forced to listen. So yeah, I have a lot of products to talk about today. Tools that I use, the techniques that I use, and how I maintain my straight hair for 2 to 3 weeks. Lately, I've been stretching my hair for like 3 weeks just because I like dread washing my hair because it takes way too long. And plus, I want to cut down on the amount of heat that I put in it. So that's also why I've been stretching it to 3 weeks. So yeah, and also before I jump to the products, a lot of people also ask how often I trim my hair. I trim my hair twice a year, not any time in particular, just when I feel like I need a trim. And I don't trim my hair when it's curly, I just trim it when it's straight. So yeah. Oh, and by the way, if my eyebrows look dark and shiny, that's because I recently just got my second session of microblading done and I have Aquaphor on them. So yeah, I just wanted to put that out there. Okay, so of course, I'm just going to start out with the shampoos and conditioners that I use. But first, I'm going to mention to you guys the shampoo and conditioner that I used this time to do my hair. So I first shampooed my hair with my Nioxin Scalp Recovery Shampoo for dry itchy scalp. And I like to use this only when my scalp is dry and itchy, which it was this time recently. And this has Perinthium Zinc in it. And it's, of course, for dandruff. It's also really good if you have dermatitis. So this is just a really good medicated shampoo for like super itchy dry scalp, and I've been having that recently, and this helps to calm my scalp when it's super itchy. It has like a really nice minty feel on the scalp, and I just really like how this feels. So I shampooed with this first this time because my scalp was super itchy. I only use it if I need it, so I did need this time. So I shampooed with that once. I do the lather, rinse, repeat. So the first wash I used that, and then the second wash I used my Redken All Soft Shampoo. I've been using this shampoo and conditioner for years, and I just really like it. My hair always turns out really soft and weightless, not super greasy and weighed down. So I find that my straight hair works a lot better with salon brands versus drugstore brands. I like drugstore brands for my straight hair, but I noticed that my hair lasts longer when I use salon brands. Because back in the day, I used to use Dove a lot, and I used to use the Pantene Beautiful Lengths, and I also like to use the Garnier Length and Strength. So those were like my go-tos for drugstore. Those are really good drugstore shampoos and conditioners if you don't want to fork out the bucks for high-end. But I just prefer to invest in high-end shampoos and conditioners. I get these at Ulta, and they last a really long time. Like, I've literally had this set for like 2 years. So that tells you a lot. So I shampooed with this a second time this time, but normally if I don't use my Nioxin shampoo, if my scalp is just feeling normal, I'll shampoo with this twice. So yeah, and of course after that I go in with the matching conditioner, the Redken All Soft Conditioner, and this is just a nice lightweight conditioner. I also like how this smells. It smells like a really soft scent. It's not too strong or overwhelming. So yeah, this is what I use this time to shampoo and condition my hair. Yeah, these bottles are huge. So yeah, just invest in the big bottles because they're going to last you a super duper long time. So that's what I use to shampoo and condition my hair. I'll really quickly mention a couple of other shampoos and conditioners that I've been using in rotation because I like to use different shampoos and conditioners so that my hair doesn't get used to one set. So I've also been really liking the Agave Healing Oil Shampoo and Conditioner. These are the smoothing ones. So this is the smoothing shampoo and this is the smoothing conditioner. They smell really good. Yeah, they have a really nice scent. I love how these smell. They work really good. They make your hair super shiny. I got these from Sephora. The last shampoo and conditioner set that I've been using in rotation, oh, this hair on it, is the Redken Extreme line, so the blue line. I had the shampoo upside down so that it's easier to come out next time I use it. So this is pretty much for distressed hair, and this helps with breakage. It also has interlock protein in it, so it has protein in it, which is really good for making sure your hair stays nice and strong and that is less prone to breakage. So yeah, I really, really like this line. It's almost empty. So yeah, those are the three shampoos and conditioner sets that I've been using recently in rotation. Like I said, so my hair doesn't get used to one. I just like to, you know, use them in rotation. And also, when you have more than one shampoo and conditioner set, the one that you're using doesn't go as fast. So if you have more than one, they last longer. Unless you have these big bottles, I mean, these still would have lasted me long even if I didn't use them in rotation. But yeah, those are the three that I've been using. I tried a lot of different shampoos and conditioners. Some people say they don't see a difference when using shampoos and conditioners. At first I thought that until I used the Moroccan oil shampoo and conditioner. The conditioner works really nicely, but the shampoo to me was a little too thick and my hair came out really, really greasy. So shampoos and conditioner really do matter when it comes to having a nice long lasting blowout. So if you don't start right, your hair is not gonna look right in the end. And after I shampooed and conditioned with my All Soft shampoo and conditioner, I deep conditioned, of course. I always deep condition. I never, ever, 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 ever skip this step, especially when I'm straightening my hair because I'm putting heat in it. So you definitely need to make sure you deep condition. Never skip deep conditioning. So this time I used my Joico K-Pack. If you guys have been following Kendra and I for a long time, you know we've been using this for super, super long. This is the Intense Hydrator Treatment for Dry Damaged Hair. I think I mentioned this in our Winter Beauty Essentials. I feel like I did. I like that it's in like a squeeze bottle. It's a lot more convenient so you don't have to like scoop in a jar. So I really like this deep conditioner a lot. I've been using it for so long for a reason because it does the job and it makes my hair extremely soft and strong. So love, love, love the K-Pack. So yeah, if you have like super, super dry hair, I highly recommend this one because it's the Intense Hydrator. So it's going to give your hair that extra moisture that it needs. So yeah, I get this from Ulta. And then the other deep conditioner that I've been using a lot recently too on my straight hair is an old product as well. This is the Macadamia Nourishing Moisture Mask. This thing has been on YouTube for years, but it's a really good deep conditioner and mine is pretty much empty, but I want to show it to you guys because I've also been using this one in rotation with my Joico K-Pack. So I used this last time I did my hair, and that's why this time I use this. So I just like to, you know, rotate them when I do my hair. So yeah, this is basically for medium to coarse hair, and it just says it reconstructs, revitalizes, and repairs the hair. So this is a really nice mask. This is mostly to me for strengthening and less for moisture. It makes my hair moisturized, but I noticed that my hair is more moisturizing with the Intense Hydrator because that's mainly what this is for, and this is more for strengthening. It says it's color safe. Pretty sure this is color safe too because I've been using it for years and I've been dyeing my hair black for a super long time. And usually my deep conditioners, I let them sit for 30 minutes to an hour, or if I'm just too lazy, I'll just go to sleep with it and rinse it out the next day, like, or if I have time. So, and I just use a plastic cap. This time I didn't have any plastic caps, so I used the Target plastic bag to deep condition my hair and it did the job. By the way, this brand you can find at a lot of different places actually. I've seen this deep conditioner at Target, I've seen it at Marshall's, TJ Maxx. So you can find this deep conditioner at a lot of different places. Okay, so after I've rinsed out my deep conditioner, that's when I get ready to go into blow drying my hair. And before I blow dry, I always like to apply a leave-in conditioner. By the way, in the clips you're seeing or about to see of me blow drying and flat ironing my hair, please excuse my appearance. I came on camera extra raw. I had pimple cream on, but this is real life, people. I don't always look like this, okay? So before I go in and detangle my hair, of course I like to put in a leave-in conditioner because that's gonna make it a lot easier to comb through your hair. So I have two leave-in conditioners to mention to you guys. I've recently been using the Shea Moisture one a whole lot that we did a video on. This is the Shea Moisture Sugar Cane Extract and Metal Foam Seed Silicone Free Miracle Styler Leave-In Treatment with Marshmallow Root. And I've been really liking this a lot. So I like to spray this in first. Like, I'll do like two or three like squirts on like each side of my head first. And then that's when I go in and start sectioning, because this is kind of like a prep for my detangling. And the reason I've started to use this and my Redken Anti-Snap is because I noticed that this Shea Moisture one makes my hair extremely, extremely soft. So that's why I really like using this. And then after that, I use my Redken Extreme Anti-Snap Anti-Breakage Leave-In Treatment for Distressed Hair. I've been using this for so long, for years and years and years. You guys can see I love Redken. It's like one of my favorite brands. I mostly get all my Redken products at Ulta. I like to go in with this on each individual section. So I'll spray like two or three squirts into my hand and apply it to each individual section, and then I'll go in and detangle with my wide tooth comb and start to twist my hair. The reason I do the twist is because it keeps my hair detangled when I'm blow drying another section. So that's why I like to do the twist in my hair. And by the way, the wide tooth comb that I'm using, I think I got it from Target or Walmart. I can't exactly remember because I've had it so long, but I'll have one similar link down below. If you don't already have a wide tooth comb, I'm sure most of us have a wide tooth comb by now, because that's like the best way to start detangling your hair before you go in and blow dry. I think it's extremely important to always use a leave-in conditioner before you go in and blow dry, because most leave-in conditioners are heat protectants and they help you detangle and help to avoid breakage. So they're just an all-around really, really necessary step. So they're just as important as a deep conditioner. So each thing that I do has a purpose. I feel like if I skip any one of these steps, my hair does not turn out the same. And some of the steps, like deep conditioning and leave-in conditioners, are more so for long-term health. Okay, so after I have my hair in the four twisties that you see, I like to go in with my Kenra Platinum Blow Dry Spray. And this is a thermal protector, but this is also a cutting down drying time product. So I have to always use this, because if not, I'm going to be blow drying all day long. I'm obsessed with this stuff. It smells amazing. This is like the only blow dry spray that I use, and I found that it has worked best for me. I like to spray this in each individual section, and then I'll go in and blow dry my hair. I used to spray it all over, but I noticed that this works best like right on the section that I'm about to blow dry. Instead of letting it sit, I like to spray it directly on that section right before I go in and blow dry. And the blow dryer that I like to use is this one. I used to have the Numi one that Kendra mentioned in her hair routine, but mine broke a while ago. I had the bright pink one. It was so pretty, but I dropped it a couple times in beauty school, like when I used to do like the blowouts with the round brush. I dropped it a couple times and it just never worked the same, and then after a while it just stopped working completely. So for the past like 2 years, I think I've been using this one. This is by the brand Solia, S-O-L-I-A. The super hot blow dryer, and I really, really like this blow dryer a lot. The only thing I don't like about this blow dryer is that it's like kind of heavy, and I feel like my Numi one was a lot lighter than this, and my arm didn't start to hurt as fast when I blow dry with my Numi, because this one is heavier, so my arms get tired really fast when using this. But this blow dryer does work really, really fast, so it's been getting the job done. And I always have to have a blow dryer attachment on my blow dryers. Like, I can't just go in with it like this, because I feel like it blows my hair everywhere. And I also feel like my hair is not as smooth if I don't use an attachment. So this is a concentration nozzle, and it basically just concentrates the heat in one direction. So it basically just smooths the hair shaft to prepare it for flat ironing. So I just personally feel like if your blow dryer ain't right, your flat iron ain't gonna be right. Like, it's not gonna be smooth and silky. People are always asking, how do you get that smooth and silky flat iron? Well, you have to have a good blow dryer and a good blow drying technique. So I always just blow dry going down. So don't go blow drying like all crazy everywhere. And I basically just follow that with my paddle brush. I like to start out with the wide tooth comb. You guys probably already saw me do that. But like after my hair doesn't have as much moisture in it, that's when I pick up my paddle brush. And the reason I did that is because when you go in with a regular paddle brush like this, because I like to use just a regular one like this. This is from Conair. I got it from Walmart, I think. It's because this can break your hair, because damp or wet hair is a lot more prone to breakage than drier hair. So that's why I go in with the wide tooth comb first to avoid breakage. And halfway through, I'll pick up my paddle brush. So I'll put down the wide tooth comb, then I'll pick up my paddle brush, and then just finish out the section that I'm blow drying. That might sound kind of complicated, but it's been working for me, and I've been doing it for the longest time. So you always want to make sure you're holding the blow dryer down in this direction. Okay, so after I look like Mufasa and I blow dried all of my hair, that's when I go in and flat iron. Usually I'll take a little bit of a break because I'm hot at this point. I'm thirsty. So I'll take like a 5-minute break and kind of let my hair cool down before I go in into flat ironing. After about 5 minutes, I'll start flat ironing. And the flat iron that I use is the Sadu. I've had this exact flat iron for almost 6 years, probably 7. This is, to me, the best flat iron out there, and I've tried so many flat irons. I used to use a Qi, but the Qi snagged my hair a lot. Let me know if you still use a Qi and they've corrected that issue, but if not, I highly recommend you jump on the Sadu bandwagon, because this flat iron is absolutely amazing. I use the wider plates. This is the 1.5 inch plate. It just helps me go a lot faster. It doesn't snag my hair. It's ceramic. It's just amazing. I just love this flat iron. Like, it just hasn't done me wrong, knock on wood, but it's amazing. It goes all the way up to 410 degrees, and I do use it all the way up to 410 degrees because if I put it on a lower setting, I have to go over my hair more than one or two times. And I only like to go over each section once or twice, no more than two times, because, you know, it creates heat damage. So that's why I put it on 410, and I just go over each section once or twice, and I do the chasing method. And I like to do my chasing method with a bristle brush. Some people like to do it with a like a rat tail comb, but I feel that the rat tail comb doesn't grab enough hairs as a bristle brush would, because the bristle brush has way more bristles than a comb has teeth. It just grabs more hairs and gives me that silky flowy, you know, look, you know, just to make sure there are no strands left behind. And it gives me better tension as well. You want really good tension while you're flat ironing and doing the chasing method, because if not, you're going to have some pieces that aren't as straight. So yeah, I find that the bristle brush just works best, and this one is from Goody, and I've had it since the 19th century. You can get bristle brushes at your beauty supply store, Walmart, Target. Probably got that one from Walmart if I can remember correctly, so yeah. So yeah, the chasing method is just always worked for me. I just always start in the back and work my way to the top of my head, and then I just do the sides and then work my way up to here. So after I'm done flat ironing, I like to go in with a light serum. I have a couple up here I'll mention to you guys briefly. Well, a few, not a couple. The one that I used this time on my hair right after I finished flat ironing is my Living Proof No Frizz Nourishing Oil. I've talked about this a couple of times in maybe a favorites video, but this is just a really good lightweight oil. If you don't like serums because you feel like they weigh your hair down, then you should probably give this one a try because it's like super duper lightweight. See, it has kind of like a watery consistency, and I like that about it. So I like to use this on my hair when it's fresh because I don't want it to be greasy. Well, I never want my hair to be greasy, but I find that I use this one more when my hair is like fresh. And I can also use it on my flyaways without my hair getting greasy up here, because I have a lot of flyaways when my hair is like fresh. I'm sure most of you guys have that issue too, like if you've just done your hair. The flyaway thing is kind of annoying, but it's kind of inevitable because your hair is like really clean and you just blow dried and straightened it, so you're gonna have some random pieces sticking up. The other serum that I like to use a lot as well, like during the time my hair is straight, like when I wrap it and stuff, is this Oblifica. I think that's how you say this brand. I've mentioned this before as well. This is the Oblifica Sea Berry Hair Serum. I love this stuff. It smells so good. This one is a little thicker, so if you have finer hair, I wouldn't recommend this. But if you have thicker, coarser hair, then you would really like this, because it is a little bit thicker and it smells amazing. So I just like to apply this on my ends sometimes before I wrap my hair. Usually after that first time, like the first time I like applied oil, like last night when I did my hair, I usually don't apply any oil for a few days just because I feel like I really don't need it. I'll just wrap my hair for days and days and days. And I usually don't need any serum unless like it rained and my hair got a little frizzy, or I worked out and my hair got a little frizzy. That's the only time I'll use a serum or oil. But I try to limit the use on serums because your hair gets greasier faster that way, but I don't use it unless I need it. And then I'm just going to mention one dry oil that I like to use on my straight hair, because you guys know I love dry oils, but I mostly really like the Organix brand. But I mostly use the OGX dry oils on my curly hair, on my curls. But this is my favorite dry oil for my straight hair. This is the Alterna Bamboo Smooth Candy Oil Dry Mist for Ultimate Frizz Control. So I like to use this also like if my hair is still fresh and I don't want to use one of my thicker serums, because this doesn't make my hair greasy. So that's why I like this. I don't want to waste it. My hair doesn't need it right now, but I'll just show you guys how it missed out. It's just really, really lightweight. It's not super heavy. It smells so good. Ugh, I love this smell. As you can see, it's kind of watery, so it's super, super light. This is not going to weigh your hair down. So this is also good for flyaways. So try a dry oil if you don't want to put like a regular oil on like up here, because I try to avoid oils as much as possible as long as I can to stretch my hair and ensure that it stays straight for long and not greasy. So a dry oil is really, really good if you want to keep your hair nice and shiny and frizz free without weighing it down. Okay, so yeah, that's pretty much it for my actual routine. Now, I get a lot of questions on how I maintain my straight hair, and I still cannot believe there are so many people that do not wrap their hair. You've been getting your hair done for years and years and years. You should know how to wrap your hair by now. I'm just saying, don't be trying to go to bed looking all cute for your man. Your man should love you in your wrap cap and out it. I'm just saying. I've been wrapping my hair since I was 12 or 13. The lady who used to do our hair when we used to get relaxers taught me and Kendra how to wrap our hair, and I never forgot how to do it because it's a lifesaver and it preserves your style. You don't want to do all that work and then try to go to bed looking cute and wake up with dents in your hair. So make sure you're wrapping your hair. It also protects your hair while you're sleeping at night. So I always, always, always like to wrap my hair. So I basically just brush it all the way down in my face, and then I just brush it around to the right, all the way around with my paddle brush. And then to smooth it out, to make it a lot easier and to make it lay down a little bit more, I go in with my bristle brush and smooth out the hair around there. So I start out with the paddle brush, and then I just finish off the wrap with the bristle brush. And I also like to use clips. So I just use these duckbill clips, and I place them on each side of the top of my wrap. And that's when I go in with my little knitted wrap cap. And I put that around, it has like a little Velcro attachment, and I put that on first to kind of like hold the wrap in place. And then I'll take out my duckbill clips, and then that's when I go in with my silk durag wrap cap. I call it a durag because that's what it looked like to me. And I put that over top of that, and then I just tie it up. So that's pretty much how I wrap my hair. I wanted to show you guys that because so many people have been asking me how I preserve my straight hair. So girl, wrap your hair, please. So yeah, I hope this wasn't too long. I pretty much covered everything. I hope I didn't forget anything. I hope you guys learned a lot from this video. I tried to give more than one like product recommendation of each thing that I like to use. Oh, I forgot to mention, you guys already saw me do this, but I like to spray this Tresemme heat tamer spray in right before I flat iron. So you guys already saw me do that, but I just forgot to mention it. But yeah, I use the Tresemme heat tamer spray, and I've been using this for years and years and years, and it protects up to 450 degrees of heat. My flat iron only goes up to 410, so I'm good. This is perfect. You can get this at any drugstore. I've been using this for so, so long. The platinum one, like the one in like the gray silvery top, it works the same as this one to me. So you can just get the original. They both work the same to me. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope that it helped you guys. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll see you guys in the next one.